Do you remember when you first met Chris Cannon?
What?
Do you remember when you first met Chris Cannon? Do you know where
you're
you are?
You're Chris Cannon.
No, I'm not Chris Cannon.
I'd say a combination of gravitas and sass. Gravisass.
Some people have said that Charlie Warner is his Kyle Evans.
I know, he wishes.
You're going to smile. All right, we'll start that over. Seriously?
That me?
Someone is going to have to explain Bernice to me before Chris leaves.
Shocked when I heard that Chris was going to be leaving. I had him pegged for a lifer.
He would email us from home, and it would just say in all caps, "Save me a piece of that," or "OMG, I'm on my way."
And I learned that he was never afraid to talk back to Adam Gassimi, which was always entertaining.
You would just politely come over when he got in, get his, whatever the recipe was, thank us, and leave.
This is for Tommy's house?
Yeah.
Sometimes he's more recognizable than Rory Johnston. That's how long he's been here.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Chris Cannon. I'm Charlie Neese. Welcome to The Breakfast Show. Before we get to our top story, let's check in with Charlie, see what it's like outside this morning.
Not bad. We've got plenty of clear skies.
Chris Cannon was here. He was an anchor once, wasn't he? He's not an anchor anymore. I'm an anchor. He's not.
Anyway, it looks like they're going to want to talk.
Ron Howes just said temperatures aren't that bad outside, but he apparently has not been outside in a while.
I am. I'm pregnant. That's why I've gained 3 pounds.
Do you know that his last name is not actually Cannon?
I had no idea. So, some investigative reporter I am. What is his last name?
His last name is Bugter.
Bugter?
Officials say this was the first incident involving a knife at Binghamton High School, and they were quick to take action.
When Chris Cannon goes to state government, will they allow him to keep the name Cannon on his ID, or will he actually have to go by Bugter?
Bugter? No.
Is it really? 20 years ago, told him to change his last name.
Why Cannon? This is the first I've heard. Are you serious?
What's his last name?
His last name is actually Bugter. Did you know that?
Bugter. There's another report on Channel 2 like that.
No, I did not know his last name was not Cannon. No, I didn't know that.
His last name is Bugter.
Really?
Yes.
No, I did not know that.
Do you think that a state agency will let him put Cannon on a badge if that's not his real last name?
It sounds to me like we've got an investigation already lined up. You know, is the PIO for the Department of Labor using a fake name on his official state ID? Wow. That's not his name, though, is it?
No, it's not.
Isn't it like Botsaris? No, that was Chris Clark.
I mean, I guess that explains why he's such a miserable person.
I feel so bad. People really don't know Chris Cannon at the end of the day.
This guy has my first name and your first name, and his last name is Bug Turd. And he's leaving to go to this. Why is this news? Why am I talking about this? I don't understand a thing.
They literally flipped through the phone book trying to figure out a last name, and they stumbled upon Cannon, and that stuck.
News Channel 5's Chris Cannon is at the winner's home right now. Chris.
We are in South Nashville where the holiday lights are shining brightly tonight.
Harry, it takes 4 days to be exact and more than 275 people to pull off a show like this.
The wind is running like a hurricane through the Minnesota timber plains of the coldest place in America.
That's a ridiculous. It should be against the law.
He's been angry since I met him. He's angry at the world. I'm surprised that he didn't sign up for that Mars thing. You know, just to leave planet Earth and go colonize Mars.
I'm going to miss the nastiness that comes out of his mouth.
You never carry that for me.
Well, in the next 2 weeks, I'm going to carry it. Just like Harry Chapman would.
He doesn't go for the easy joke. He'll just kind of quietly say something, and you kind of look at him like, did he just say that? But it's always right on time.
It's very windy. It's so windy, it's almost moving my hair.
Or every 6 months, he bitches and moans and says he's going to leave. He's done with the business. And he's done this for, what, 10 years? Yeah. So it's kind of like the boy who cried wolf. The Bugter who cried wolf. See, I just came up with that.
The amount of times that Chris Cannon has gone and bought stamps to mail in his stories over the last 4, 5, 6 years, he must have spent a fortune.
But you know, I want him to come and be a guest on Morning Line and talk to us about unemployment benefits. I look forward to that.
Nope.
I don't have any sea turtles. Go fish. Oh, hey, Chris. How are you? Playing a little go fish. Oh, it's not anchor go fish, but, you know, it does the job. And I'm snacking on my favorite food with you, huh? Popeyes. Remember that? Mm-hmm. You want to know what I'm having? Just kidding. Well, this is it, my friend. I can't believe it. You're venturing out into a new, wonderful world beyond news. You're going to do a great job. To think, I knew you when that glowing baby face was all natural. We've been friends a long time. Yes, we have. And I have so many fond memories. I mean, watching you practice in front of the news cam at the Williamson AM, to being a front row fan of our Club 05 dance parties. And you've always been such a loving friend. I mean, who else would make out with me in the morning meeting just for my pitch? Chris Cannon. Mm-hmm. Also, you've always been very supportive. I mean, who else would have come to tell me when I ordered that overpriced red velvet cake of Clint's for his birthday? You were the first one to let me know. Kristen, that is not real cream cheese frosting. Now come to think of it, you did that with the lemon pound cake too.
I can die painting a picture of my life and my dreams. Suddenly this crazy world made more sense to me. Well, I heard today and I couldn't help but sing along, 'cause every time I hear that song, and I go back to a two-tone short bed Chevy, driving my first love out to the levee, living life with no sense of time.
Hi everyone, and thanks for joining us. I'm Chris Cannon. We have a big Williamson Weekly planned for you. Here's a look at what's coming up during the next half hour. Holly Trolley. Franklin's Trolleys will put you in the holiday spirit this month.
Well, the rain has finally stopped, but the wind has picked up and the cool temperatures have returned. Trolley is here now to give us a check of the forecast.
Yeah, not bad today, at least to start today. We've got plenty of sunshine as the sun's just now coming up.
3, 2, 1. So the big question now, if you're... Is that going to work? One. So the big question now, if your company's 401k has... I want to say matching. This is a camera. They go out in the field. Do you continue to put that money in a 401k or save it somewhere else? Did you continue to send us that one up? 3, 2, 1. So the big, oh shit.
Oh.
Taking that back. 3, 2, 1. Company's matching money has gone kaput.
Hold on.
I didn't like that one. So the big question now, if your money, you need.
You good?
Nah, let me do it one more time. Just to be safe, or save it somewhere else. Ray Johnston. That's fine. I'll play time again.
All right, happening right now. One of the biggest weeks, of course, for country music. The CMA Awards will be handed out on Wednesday, but first, ASCAP is giving out the honors. Let's go to Chris Cannon. He is live on the red carpet over at the Omni Hotel. Well, actually, that's Cuthbert Langley right there. That's not Chris Cannon right there. Exciting week and an exciting night,
there we
Chris.
Are.
Anything that's on the roads, any of that wetness is going to freeze up and could be a hot mess out here come rush hour tomorrow morning. So you'll want to leave a little extra time and be careful. We are live over the interstate tonight. Chris Cannon, News Channel 5 HD.
All right, Chris.
What kind of journalist says traffic's going to be a hot mess? I mean, he couldn't think of a better adjective.
Taking place throughout the weekend and the ticket prices to get into those different events. We'll have more coming up tonight at 6 o'clock. We are live at Meharry Medical College. Chris Cannon, News Channel 5 HD.
And he came out with the HD because it's just so ingrained in him. I think it serves him right.
Chris Cannon is
I mean, really, let's be honest. He's the guy that you hate to love and love to hate. He's kind of like J.R. Ewing's wife, right?
Chris Cannon leaving the bright lights and glamour of TV for the Department of Labor. Who knew the guy liked pregnant women so much? You know, remember, it's all about breathing when you're helping women through labor. You know, short little breaths, and then you don't want to push until it's too late. I know you know all this because, after all, that's where you're going.
You just couldn't handle doing another story about a song, about a pickup truck, or a dog, or heartbreak. That must have been what did it in, or maybe it was you couldn't bear to spend another day in that newsroom with Chris Conti and Cuthbert Langley, but whatever it was, it is our business's loss and bureaucracy's gain. Best of luck in the new job, and think of it this way. When Cuddy or Conti get fired, you can help them get the unemployment benefits they so don't deserve.
It is cold out here, that is for sure. And again, we said it a million times, if you don't have to stand out here like we are, don't. Just stay inside and watch TV. We are live on Jefferson Street. Chris Cannon, News Channel 5.
Chris, thanks. What a way to send him off after 12 years, his final live shot.
I know.
He's leaving us to go to a new job on Monday.
I miss you already.
What a pro he is. He did a great job today. Chris, thank you.
I think we're losing. It's almost like the uncle of the newsroom who would say something funny every now and then, but pretty much was serious.
I'm so proud of you. And I know you're going to do a great job at the state. And I want you to remember all of the great things about Channel 5, like our beloved friend Kevin. Okay, Chris Cannon, bye-bye. He's really gonna miss you.
And by the way, I didn't want you to feel lonely, so I've given Kevin your home address and your personal phone number. That's my gift to you.
Cannon, you're finally retiring after talking about it forever. So I hope you're enjoying your cake and eating a lot of it. Just take your belt off. Don't even worry about it. Eat the whole damn thing. It'll be fine, I promise you. But congratulations. This is definitely a milestone.
Dear Chris Cannon, on your very last day of working in television news, I wrote a poem for you as a reflection of your service to the many communities you've worked for over the many, 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 many years that you've been alive. And it starts like this. Roses are red, violets are blue. We met in Evansville, Indiana, but you were stanky then too. Then on my first day at News Channel 5, you straight up pretended I wasn't alive. But all it took was a day and a cookie to get me some of that coworker nookie.
When you're working with a reporter like Chris, it's just so great that he's just so patient with you and just understanding of what you're just trying to do.
He carries your tripod a lot, or he doesn't carry your tripod?
Let me grab that for you.
No, it's all right.
You never know what kind of Cannon you're going to get. I mean, he's consistently miserable, you know, so you have that going for you. You know, it's like there's miserable, and then there's just miserable, and then there's miserable, and Cannon kind of falls somewhere in between the two.
He comes in walking very slow, like almost at a shuffle's pace, you know, it's just kind of sauntering in, setting down, setting down all of his bags, and he just sits at the computer and just stays quiet. That's when you know he's not having a good day.
Problem is, I don't give a so it really isn't.
I do not think he considers me to be a friend. Some days he does, some days he doesn't. It just depends on his sugars, as I like to say.
He was, you know, laying it out like, oh, they've got to do this and that and this. And I was just like, Chris, man, I've had a long week and this is my Friday. I just want to get through the day. And he's never let me forget that.
It's a way to find a audio booth where he could record, where it wouldn't be so echoey. So I suggested there was a folding table with some drapes around it. I said, this is our only solution.
Do you think that was one of those moments that made him say, I need another job?
That may have been the straw that broke the camel's back.
You know, I can still remember the day I was sitting in the newsroom. You were right next to me, and I heard the infamous grunt. And I quickly looked over and realized it was not just Chris Cannon or Chris Buckter. There was another person there.
Well, you would think Bernice is a diabetic. But Bernice likes to eat the sugar all day, every day.
Actually, you know, he's had some good Botox. He has, but this last one, good God help him. Just a little out of control. No more Groupons, Chris.
Sharp. And I'm Chris Cannon, and we are live on the red carpet on country music's biggest night.
Who will be crowned the next Nashville star? That is the top prize in this nationally televised talent search.
This business, people don't stay around a long time, but he's been here for years. And so for him to leave, that's going to be even a bigger void because he's been here so long. And he's just always associated with News Channel 5.
We are losing a piece of the fabric of News Channel 5.
When you see a note up there that someone who's been here that long is leaving, it just kind of takes you, it's surprising.
Hey there, Chris Cannon. I've got precisely 3 inspiring words to share with you to help you find success in your new career. That's sausage, factory, fire. If you put in that much effort every day in your new job, you're sure to find success. Wish you luck, buddy.
Chris, you left your mark in Nashville over a 12-year period. I always perceived you as one of the best storytellers out there, and also one of the best-dressed reporters. You always look good on camera. We're going to miss your input and your ability to tell the news in Middle Tennessee. All the best of luck.
You're going to do awesome, and some of my very favorite memories in my career were with you in the News Channel 5 newsroom. From Reporter Row to Nightside Vacuums, TV News is going to miss you. And now that the state of Tennessee is paying you all of that money and you get holidays off, you have no more excuses. You have to come to Seattle, see the Space Needle, and me. And Janet, you better get here soon.
We're hoping this means that you'll finally make it out to Seattle as you've been promising for the last 2 years. We love you, Chris Cannon, and we wish you the best.
As I hear you're moving to the nation's capital, which means you're going to be seeing a lot more of this. Yikes, why? Have fun, man. Good luck.
We will miss you on this side, but we'll get to work with you on the other side, hopefully.
And Conti just told me it's the Tennessee Department of Labor that you're going to, so... Sorry, forget what I said. Good luck.
In all seriousness, I just want to say congratulations. I know you've been looking for a while, and I couldn't be happier for you. And as your friend, happy you're sticking around.
You're going to miss us as much as we're going to miss you, I think. But go do it, and if you don't like it, please don't hesitate to come back. We are always here for you.
Proud of you. I'm glad that you got this job with the state.
I'm forever grateful and proud that he's a friend. I will, for the record, miss Chris Cannon, or is that really his name?
Well, 12 years is a good bit of equity to put into one place. I'm wishing you all the best and hoping that your next assignment will be a lot of fun and very rewarding. The best of luck.
I'm going to miss you, Cannon.
It is approximately 2:40 on Chris Cannon's last day. We're live over here. You're welcome, Chris. I can get the door for you anytime. Just go ahead, make your way over on the red carpet to our brand new live truck that we have just for you. Sure, there you go. Yep. Chris, how many live shots do you have today?
I've done 7 already, and I have 8 more between the hours of 4 and 7. So, yeah, I'm not really good at math otherwise. I wouldn't be here now in the snow.
Oh, look who it is.
What a beautiful way to end a remarkable career. Chris Cannon, everybody! Chris Cannon! Yes! Chris Cannon, ladies and gentlemen! Thank you and good night.
Only got 100 years.
But you know what? I changed things up. You will too. Good luck, my friend. Okay, Livia. All of it.